In part 1, we showed the basic techniques for disassembling the valves and valve springs. We did this on a fairly new cylinder head. When you're dealing with a used cylinder head, disassembly can be a little less easy. In part 2, we'll show what can go wrong, or what can be more difficult, with old cylinder heads. The use of the valve spring tensioner, we have already explained in part 1, in detail. We start with the exhaust valve of a 1600, type 1 engine. The cylinder head is attached with two M10 threaded rods, as explained in part 1. You position the grippers on both sides, as best as possible centrally on the valve head, and on the spring retainer. You squeeze the valve spring, and the valve keepers come off. Here we see what happens at the bottom of the cylinder head. If the valve keepers are not released enough, you can use the small handle of the valve spring tensioner to adjust the range. To do this, you must first relax the tensioner. Make sure that the valve keepers are still firmly in place before you relax the spring tensioner. When the cylinder head lies flat in the vise, it is sometimes a bit of a search to get the valve keepers out. Now you may relax the spring tensioner, do so very gradually. The spring retainer is now free and can be removed. The valve spring is fully relaxed and can also be removed. You may now slide the valve out of the valve guide. Make sure the valve stem is clean before sliding it out of the cylinder head. This valve slides, without hindrance and almost without force, out of the valve guide. The diagnosis of the valves we discuss in video 4 of our series on engine diagnosis. We now disassemble the intake valve. Take the time to put the spring tensioner grippers in place properly. This spring retainer is fairly tight. On an old cylinder head, the valve keepers will be stuck by, among other things, dried up oil residue. We use some grease on an Allen wrench here to make it easier to get the valve keepers loose. It would be easier with a magnet, that may, if you know now that the valves and valve keepers will be replaced. If you are thinking of reusing the parts, this may make the valves and keepers magnetic, which is not a good idea. Take the time to clean the valve stem. The grooves where the valve keepers fit can be very contaminated. We'll use penetrant oil. Let it soak in a bit. If necessary, also use brake cleaner to clean everything before sliding the valve through the valve guide. With a little patience, the valve will come out almost by itself. If you feel any resistance, try cleaning the valve stem again, until the valve can slide through the valve guide without resistance. As mentioned in part 1, with this mounting technique on the vise, you will have to move the cylinder head several times. You will also have to move the M10 threaded rods to other holes to reach all the valves. We have now placed the cylinder head vertically in the vise. The advantage is that both sides are clearly visible, and you can better center the grippers. The disadvantage is that the valve keepers can sometimes fly far away. For the last valve of this 1600 engine, we show how you can also use the workshop rag to prevent the valve keepers from flying away. This still went pretty smoothly. Removing the valve keepers is always a challenge. It helps to push the valve spring in deeper, which requires you to adjust the reach of the valve spring tensioner. Relax the valve spring tensioner gradually so that the valve spring does not fly away. Use a rag to hold it back if necessary. Clean the valve stem and gently push the valve out of the cylinder head. Now we will disassemble the valves from a cylinder head where one valve is jammed. You can see that the valve springs are corroded on the cylinder side. When we turn the cylinder head over, you can see that one intake valve remains open. The valve stem is stuck in the valve guide due to poor lubrication, engine overheating, or not changing the engine oil regularly. Pushing in the valve spring tensioner is not possible, the valve is very stuck. From the looks of it, not only the stuck valve is a problem. The first exhaust valve is also tight. It is the valve keepers that are jammed in the spring retainer. Tapping with a hammer on the spring retainer and on the head of the valve stem usually helps to release the parts. We use a heavy hammer with soft brass head so as not to cause unnecessary damage to parts that are still usable, such as the spring retainer and spring. The spring retainer can be moved without much force, and the valve keepers come off the valve stem by themselves. We use a magnet here to get the valve keepers out, which is faster. This should be done only if you are sure that the valve and valve keepers will be replaced. Otherwise, use a small screwdriver. Relax the spring tensioner, you can see that it happens quite explosive here. If necessary, use a rag around the spring retainer and valve spring to cushion the forces. After a thorough diagnosis, it will have to be seen if the valve spring needs to be replaced. The diagnosis of these parts is discussed in video 4 of our engine diagnostic series. Before sliding the valve out of the valve guide, clean the grooves in the valve stem with brake cleaner or penetrant oil. The first exhaust valve still comes loose from the cylinder head fairly well. We now show the disassembly of the second exhaust valve from the inside of the cylinder head. The range of the valve spring tensioner you can adjust with this lever. Now the valve keepers can be removed. The valve spring tensioner can be relaxed. All valve springs are in bad shape at first glance, but diagnosis will help decide which parts need replacement. The valve stem gets a thorough cleaning, and then the valve can come out. This valve also comes out pretty smoothly. The first inlet valve spring is fairly loose. The valve spring relaxes with brute force. The valve spring is very corroded. After cleaning the spring, we will have to see if it is still usable. The valve spring diagnosis we discuss in video 4 of our series on engine diagnosis. The valve itself is stuck in the valve guide. We apply penetrant oil, hoping the valve can be disassembled without damage. Meanwhile, we tackle the last valve, which is this one that jammed. Pressing the valve spring is not so difficult, the valve keepers are fairly loose. We now use a rag to hold back the spring retainer and valve spring while relaxing the spring tensioner. In video 4 of our engine diagnostic series, we will test the strength of the valve springs. It will then have to be seen if this valve spring is damaged. We'll let the penetrant oil do its job. But even after leaving it overnight, the valves are still stuck. The only solution is to knock the valves out of the valve guides. The valve stem diameter of this cylinder head is 7.9 millimeters. A 6 millimeter pin driver is suitable for pushing the valve stem through the valve guide. We already know that the valve guide and the valve will have to be replaced. We will discuss replacing the valve guide in video 21 of this series. This video deals with the cylinder head revision. Warming up the cylinder head for a good 2 minutes can help reduce the pressure on the valve stem. If you want to reuse the cylinder head, you should try to do as little damage as possible to keep the budget under control. The second inlet valve is also well stuck, even after letting penetrant oil work in and heating the cylinder head. The only option, here too, is to knock the valve out of the valve guide. The valve and valve guide are definitely in need of replacement. We discuss replacing the valve guide in video 21 of this series. This video deals with the cylinder head overhaul. If the cylinder head is not cracked, an overhaul can be considered. Especially when it comes to original VW cylinder heads, which are rare and no longer available. Although at first glance you would think that this cylinder head is not salvageable, after a thorough cleaning, sometimes it may not be all that bad. You will need to perform a comprehensive diagnosis first to assess what the best solution is. In video 4 of our engine diagnostic series, we explain how to diagnose the valves and valve springs. In video 5 of that same series, we will look at what to look out for when you want to reuse cylinder heads. With these two parts on valve disassembly, we have tried to show all the possible scenarios you can encounter. In part 3, we will show valve assembly. More information about all the parts and tools used in this video series can be found as comments under each video on our YouTube channel. See you soon.